Chryslers. For the Chrysler is a well-traveling car, tolerant of abuse and virile in a fray. And the Cheyenne were people of the far horizon, always on the move, war-partying it up, chasing the buffalo and the good times. Running north to see their cousin the Sioux, and south again when their welcome wore out. They'd go. The whole nation packed into upwards of 500 Newports, generally white four-door models, gussied up with war paint, zigzagged on the fenders. The back seats piled high with teepee skins, lodge poles, firewood, squalling kids, pemmican, all that Cheyenne caboodle, rolling along on big, underinflated white wall tires. Shotgun, skirts hiked up and dirty toes propped on the dashboard. The women suckled babies and fooled with the radios. While the braves up and down shifted, jockeying for position. Each one of them as handsome as Elvis Presley, before he got all weird and fat and Vegas. Chrysler after Chrysler, sliding through the grass, under a sky that went blue.